Welcome back to Change India, an agenda for the next Prime Minister. And today we are talking about how to get the investment kick going in the economy. And point number six on our agenda for the next Prime Minister is something that again has been spoken about for possibly a decade now and not done, which is bring competition in banking, more competition. Some has come in, but much more. But the point that hasn't been done is really deepen and develop your bond market. So I'm going to pick that second part of the point and go straight to Manish. Manish, we've talked about it. What is holding up the development of the bond market, and how can the new Prime Minister, when he comes in, get it done?
There is a fundamental issue in India that we save, say, about $600 billion a year, but half of it is still not coming into the financial markets. It's still going into hard assets, where people are physically buying real estate or they're physically buying gold. And I think what the message simply seems to be that we don't trust the financial instruments that this government creates. We don't trust our currency, and therefore we look for stores of value. So the ideas of things like bringing in inflation-linked bonds, the ideas of getting banking deeper into, you know, India, the idea of trying to make gold a monetizable instrument, the idea of making real estate a lot more transparent, these are ideas which will have to get concretized and taken forward. And also, unless you create longer term pools of capital, you aren't going to develop a bond market, because you can't be running on, you know, 12-month and 24-month money in the bond markets as well.
But what is holding us back from doing that, Manish? What is holding us back from having 10-year bonds, 15-year bonds?
We don't create instruments which get people to save on that basis, because everyone in our country seems to be thinking about 12 months and 36 months as, you know, the definition of long term. So completely forget about 10 years and 20 years. And the way to crack it would have been, apart from LIC, which seems to be the only pool, is to create a pension culture in the country where people do this forced saving, like you have in Singapore. You've also got it in Chile and countries like that. And that also doesn't just solve the bond market, but also solves a source of long-term domestic equity market getting developed.
Right.
Because frankly, the risk capital domestically isn't available.
Okay, let me, Saugata, come to you on the bond market as well as competition in banking. We've said give many more licenses than you are giving, get many more banks in, allow a lot of mergers and acquisitions, a lot of consolidation, and let's get some public sector banks also to become larger. India doesn't have really large banks. We've got very small, tiny banks. So what needs to be done here?
I think this is one area, frankly, where I think we are far, far more advanced than in the other areas. I think steps are actually being taken now in the banking sector, definitely. I'm not very sure of the desirability of this huge big bang, 13 banks coming in together. I think this has the potential to create disruption in the sector. Mm-hmm. But what is now emerging with this new structure that is being thought, different types of banks, some large investment banks, some large universal banks, banks with enough scale to compete in the global markets, etc. The process of continuous licensing. So it's not just
exactly
issuing licenses.
That's what we've said. You should not have a window which opens and closes. Keep it open.
Keep it open. Absolutely.
It open.
As and when any suitable appropriate candidate comes in, give him a license. So
right.
that's done. In terms of the bond markets, again, you come back to your basic question on your fiscal deficits and etc. The problem with developing a bond market is we do not have a good benchmark sovereign yield curve. Because without that curve, you will not be able to develop, because there is nothing to benchmark
right.
your rate.
So how do we get that done quickly?
Fiscal deficit,
okay.
Again.
You fine, so we are back to the macros.
Back to the macros.
Repair your macros. That's and right. Everything is okay. Dheeraj, quick summary.
I think a lot of this stuff is difficult to get done, but it should be done. And I think, as you said, a lot of this has been debated for a very long time. And I think, I mean, as the panelists have said, it's very easy. I mean, banking licenses is one thing which is very, very easy. There's absolutely no reason to open it once in a decade. I mean, this should be done on a regular basis. There are all kinds of debates whether corporate should be allowed, whether these people... let it be open for everyone. Pick candidates on merit. Let's get competition in. Let's privatize
some of the smaller public sector banks.
Absolutely no need for banking to be necessarily in the public
right,
sector.
Right.
Those days are gone. So
right.
there are lots of options, lots of things which can
right.
be done by the next prime minister.
Right. Okay, now we've got points number 7 and 8. You can't argue too much about it. So I'm going to read these out to you. but then bring in a bit of the audience reactions. Point number seven is decentralized approvals. Allow a single window at the state level. Now, this is something that should be just done. I don't think anyone can really have anything against it. And the eighth point is also something which should be just done, because it's all about transparency. Digitize processes related to registration and clearances. Have time-bound clearances. Have everything on a website, so the journey of an application through the government system can be easily tracked. So points 7 and 8 are really not up for debate. They should be just done. So I'm going to get the audience in with something which is on their mind. Yes.
I have a question, like how can this be done, like this whole e-governance thing like we are talking about, without having a good cyber law? Like this IT act that we have is too vague to implement.
I think that's a very good contribution. So on the agenda of the Prime Minister should be to get a nice modern cyber law done. And then all of these e-governance issues can come in. There was someone raising their hand there. Yes.
Sir, as India is known as a country of parallel economies, and there in every street and every mohalla, there are many persons who are into financial business. They normally lend money and finance the persons. Then why not government is having some laws or some products like that, so that the fund that is into parallel economy can come into the products?
Absolutely, no question about that. I think that.
But secondly, I want to add something.
Yes.
Say, as far as inflation issue was there, then again government tried to ban gold import. In that case, they have introduced inflation index bonds.
Yes.
But in that case, the performance was inflation and. Index bonds.
It hasn't done so well because the returns are still not being seen as attractive. Let me go across to Manish now. Manish, we are running a bit out of time here. You've heard the debate amongst all our experts and our audience. Give us a quick summary of this segment and then we'll get on.
Raghav, quickly, the point I wanted to make was this, that when we use words like approvals and clearances, we still run with a mindset that the government is a lord which is going to hand out something rather than a facilitator of business. So, if you want to change behavior over here, just opening a single window won't do.
Okay.
And this is the single most debilitating fact for any entrepreneur, that he feels like a beggar each time he goes out. I think the opposite must also apply, that whether it's the Prime Minister, the Chief Minister, the District Collector, right down to every level, they must put out details of how much investment have they attracted in their tenure.
Right.
How much jobs did they create in their tenure.
Right.
How quickly did they approve any application which was put forward.
Right.
And reasons for delay. So there is a opposing pressure as well on the administration.
That's
as servants of society rather than people who are granting out largesse.
Okay, so that's an interesting value addition to our point on decentralized approvals, allow a single window. You're saying actually put performance benchmarks of individual performers, people who are supposed to deliver on a website. So we benchmark that as well. That's a good thought. You stay right there, get onto our website, thinkindia.in.com, give your thoughts, and we'll be back after a very short break.